You see, dear ones, you exist within this world, but you are not of it. You are the eternal spirit, while the forms within this world are temporal, confined in space and time, and defined by the laws of manifestation in this realm. You, dear ones, you are the eternal spirit, beyond all definition, for you are the creator of definition itself. You define yourselves as an experience. You define yourselves as a being, as a human being, as a father or a son, as a mother or a daughter. You define yourself as a certain age, as a certain existence of likes and dislikes, as a certain habit of emotional patterns, of mental thoughts. You define yourself in limitation through the workings of your thinking mind. This, dear ones, this is what is keeping you from realizing that which you truly are. It is the mind. It is the definition that it imposes upon the eternal spirit to have this experience of this world at this time within eternal creation. So, dear ones, where do you begin? Where does the path to enlightenment start? Where, dear one, where does it take you, and when will it be fulfilled? For these questions arise within the mind, yet the answers themselves are beyond any experience that the mind can comprehend. So you see, dear one, it is a deeper yearning from beyond your mind that prompts you to ask these questions about who you are. It is the yearning of the spirit to unfold itself, the spirit to know itself, the spirit to free itself within this world of manifestation. For enlightenment is not the escape. It is not the escape of suffering. It is not the escape of forms within this world. Enlightenment, dear ones, is the spreading of your wings, the sharing of your love, the expression of your true self as blissful life in this realm, in all realms, in all forms and manifestations. Enlightenment, dear one, is not the removal of suffering. It is the knowing and the expression of that which you truly are. And you will find, dear ones, that as you come to know and express yourself, your love, your peace and stillness more fully, you will find that suffering no longer exists. You will find, dear one, that separation was only an illusion of this thinking mind. You will realize that all of life, that all that you see and know, exists within your own self, is being created from the depths of your own self, and will be embraced as you. Embraced as you, dear ones. All of life will be embraced as you when you know the truth of who you are. Cast aside, dear ones, what you have been taught. Cast aside the teachings of the religions of the past. Cast aside the belief in political control. Cast aside, dear ones, all ideas that seek to impose constraints, restraints upon the expression of yourself, upon the knowing of yourself. Cast aside all definitions that you have been given about who you are. Cast aside, dear ones. Surrender. Give up yourself. Give up your knowing and be as you are. Allow the unfoldment of your true self to happen. Allow the unfoldment of the divine love within your heart to be shared within this world. dear ones. The path to enlightenment is the path to you, back unto your heart, beyond the experience of distance traveled, nor direction. For you see, dear ones, you exist right here and right now. The knowing of you, the experience of you, need not be achieved through the act of creation. You need not create any new experience to know yourself. Instead, dear ones, simply give up that which is complicating your perception of that which you are. Give up all the thoughts within your mind, all the attachments with objects within your world. Simply surrender these addictions, these attachments. Surrender your own mental confusion, which is only an array of conflicting thoughts. Surrender these and simply be as you are. And you will learn, dear ones, that which you are has always been present. That which you are has always existed. It is beyond creation, for it is the uncreated source through which all life is manifest. Can you understand this, dear ones? That you cannot create the experience of your own self. You can only choose to give up that which is covering it over, so that you may experience it more clearly. For each and every one of you, right here and right now, has always been existing as the Divine Self. Can you understand this, dear ones? That which you are, right here and right now, is your own divinity. Yet you choose, dear ones, you choose to instead empower that which exists on the surface of yourself within this world. You choose to ignore the greater truth that you are, and you choose to empower all the ideas of limitation that you have, all your ideas of likes and dislikes, of should and should not. You choose, dear one, to empower the illusion and ignore the truth. So, dear ones, simply surrender. Simply surrender your desire to control. Simply surrender your desire to seek the truth. For the desire to seek is itself creating the imprisonment that you are trying to free yourself from. For you cannot seek your own self, for you already are your own self. You need only surrender the desire to find that which you believe you do not already have. You need to surrender all that keeps you from being just as you are.